Our region's business is sponsored by PNC for the achiever in you. Welcome to Our Region's Business with your host, Bill Flanagan.
Today on Our Region's Business, same-sex marriage and your financial plan, what every newlywed couple needs to know. Plus, set ISIS aside, tips on unlocking business opportunity in the Middle East. But first, IT isn't just for software engineers anymore. In fact, information technology is one of the most in-demand skill sets that's required across our region's economy, and well-paying jobs may not even require a four-year degree. ImaginePittsburgh.com and the Pittsburgh Regional Alliance have released their first quarterly report on the region's workforce, and the importance of IT skills may surprise you no matter what industry you're interested in. Dr. Rasu Shrethra is Chief Innovation Officer at UPMC, and Jim Futrell is Vice President, Market Research and Analysis with the Pittsburgh Regional Alliance, an affiliate of the Allegheny Conference, which is, of course, a co-producer of this program. Welcome. Good to see you both. Thanks for coming. Yeah, Imagine Pittsburgh and the PRI took a pretty deep dive on sort of the workforce. Biggest finding, you think, Jim, when you took a look at it?
Well, I think the one thing that really surprised us was that when we were looking at the job postings on ImaginePittsburgh.com.
There's what, 26,000, 27,000 at any given time?
Yeah, and what we discovered was that 57% of them required some sort of technical or computer training.
57%? More than half, almost two-thirds?
Right, and wow. Then we did a little bit more digging into who tends to employ people in computer-related occupations. And you know, while a lot of the information technology software design companies rank highly, at the top of the list were corporate headquarters and corporate support operations, colleges and universities were in there, professional scientific and technical service firms. So we found that it really is wide ranging, that really technology touches everything these days.
Well, it does, and it even touches healthcare. I mean, honestly, you go to the doctor today, you got some digital device they're poking you with or wrapping around you or whatever. It's pervasive in your industry.
Absolutely. So what we've done at UPMC is we've embraced innovation in healthcare IT to really drive and transform the face of delivering healthcare. Right, so as we talk about how healthcare is moving from where we are today to where it needs to be, we're actually double downing on innovation and we're leveraging IT to really transform how we're delivering healthcare to our patients across the board.
Well, is this, we've heard about electronic records and digital records and stuff like that. I take it you're trying to go beyond that into sort of another whole level of how you leverage IT?
Absolutely. So if the first phase was really in us moving from analog and paper and film to digital and paperless and filmless, the next phase is for us to really rise above these silos of information systems and bring that patient story to life. We're in the pursuit of intelligence and analytics to really drive decisions in terms of what we do for our patients and how we drive not just excellence in disease management, but really focus on wellness. And we believe that this discussion around disease is good, and we need to have more of that. But disease management is cost acceleration, and wellness management is really cost deceleration. Hmm. So we're leveraging IT and innovation to really get us to that point.
Well, that's kind of the kind of story we hear, not just across a lot of industries these days.
Oh, absolutely. I know that some people have said BNY Mellon, one of our oldest, most iconic corporations, is now a technology company with a bank wrapped around it.
Well, I've heard PNC is one of the largest employers of software engineers in Pittsburgh, too. So you think about banking is really an IT industry these days.
Absolutely, yeah. It's no longer tellers. Who goes to tellers anymore? That banks are closing branches and moving all of that into the cyberspace.
So what does that mean in terms of our ability to supply the people that these companies need? How well equipped are we as a region?
Well, I think that's going to be one of the challenges going forward. We produce roughly, the colleges and universities here, roughly 1,500 people with IT degrees. At this moment, there's roughly 4,000 postings for computer-related occupations on Imagine Pittsburgh. Mm-hmm. And I think the other part of the story, though, is if you look at the 20 main computer-related occupations, seven of them do not require a four-year degree. Hmm. You can get a job in those areas with certification or a two-year degree. So there's opportunities across the entire spectrum.
Wow, that's is that true too? I would think clearly to develop some of the new technologies you're talking about. I'm sure you have a stable of software engineers out there at your operation at Bakery Square. But at the end of the day, you need people who are comfortable using this equipment too.
Yes, absolutely, indeed. So what we've seen in the last several years, and we've been around at the TDC, the Technology Development Center at UPMC, for the last 4 years. We've grown tremendously. We've grown in the last 4 years from essentially just a handful of individuals to 150 3 months ago to about 190 today.
Gee.
And we're continuing to grow tremendously, very rapidly across the board. And I'm a physician myself, and what I always say is you don't really need a stethoscope around your neck to make a difference in the life of a patient. You can be a programmer, a developer, a web designer. You can have a mouse in your hands and you can still make a difference in the life of a patient. And that's the pursuit that we're after at UPMC and specifically at the TDC in really trying to leverage innovation and take things to the next level.
And you've been hiring, clearly, still hiring. I mean, are you able to find people? Is it a challenge?
It's an interesting problem to have, right? We do require skill sets that are varied, really, across the board. There is a wealth of individuals, a number of individuals that we continue to hire from Pittsburgh, even at UPMC, as we look at the variety of skill sets that we have across UPMC, and we're, you know, right-sizing in a number of different areas. What we're doing is we're really, like I mentioned earlier, double-downing on innovation in healthcare IT. So there are a number of hires and movements even within UPMC. We're reaching out to across the region and hiring, an increasing number of individuals. And there are certain types of candidates that, you know, we can't find in the region, and we look elsewhere. But we've been attracting talent into Pittsburgh, which is really interesting. And I think Pittsburgh is growing in its reputation for being a center for innovation and health IT, which is fantastic from a perspective.
That is great. And the Workforce Quarterly report really makes that case, that there's a lot of opportunity here and more to come.
Right. And it's just a matter of making sure your skills match up with what's out there.
All right, you can find the report at workforcequarterly.com. Jim Futrell, Dr. Shrestha, thank you so much.
Appreciate it. Thanks very much. Yeah.
Next up, is there any such thing as a safe haven to do business in the Middle East these days? Well, we'll find out when our region's business returns. Stay with us.